Hopefully you guys can see my screen. Okay. Andrew has already introduced me. Jhene Gwembere, one of the technical consultant at Sage. Today's agenda is basically how to secure your Sage X3 environment. We recommend that you use certificates, right? And what they will simply do is to protect or encrypt data that is being transported over your internet protocols. So that is the simplest version. I will go into a bit more detail on how the certificates does that actual protection. Okay. So what is it that is required? So you are required basically to purchase your certificates from a public third party or certificate providers. Then you generate your certificate or a key that will be used on your Syracuse server. You register or you simply install the certificate on the web server. Then you set up your X3 to communicate using HTTPS or port 443. That's the default port. You can change it to any other port, right, over in SSL. So it's just a secure socket layer there. Then I'll also, talk about best practices and what to look out for, basically. Okay. So what is HTTPS? Okay, so it is just a secure communication, right, over your internet traffic, right? So you need anything that is being communicated over internet to be encrypted. So what the certificate simply does there is allow you to pass certain credentials to the server, then the server will say okay, or the web browser will say okay, it is actually a recognized security layer, then it will pass back the information using the credentials that are on your certificates, of course. Right. So on our online help, we have, right, so if you wanted to start the installation with certificates, we have a step-by-step guide on the online help on how to install certificates. Yeah. Okay. Then, okay, so I will explain a bit on what exactly will be taking place if we protect our internet traffic with certificates. Okay, so you have a web browser, right? So X3 being a web application, you actually access it through a web browser, right? So the first thing that will happen is your web browser, when you put in your URL on your web browser, right, the web browser will connect to a web server. So it's a request that it's doing to a web server. So it is requesting to be identified by the web server, right? Then the server will send a copy of its certificate, right? Including the server public key, Right. So on step two, so the first is the request for identification from the browser to the server. Then the server will say, okay, here are the credentials. So it will send you a copy of the SSL certificate, including the server's public key. Then the browser will check the certificate root against listed and trusted CAs, right? Certificate authorities, right? So it will also check whether the certificate is unexpired, unrevoked, and whether it is actually a common name that is valid for the website that you are trying to connect to, right? So if the browser gets all the credentials that it requires, right, then it actually creates or encrypts a session and send back to the server, right, using the server's public key. Right, then the server will decrypt the session using the its own private key, not public, but its own private key, right, and sends back an acknowledgement for that particular session to start. Okay, so once that process, that is on step number four there, so the web server will then say, okay, using the private key, the session has been decrypted and you can actually now access the information that you are requesting access to onto the server. Okay, then step number five, there is just a server and browser now encrypts all transmitted data within the session, right? So that session that you have established to the server, right, the whole data is transmitted in an encrypted format, right? So that is what a certificate will give you, right? So there are about five steps. First, you are requesting identification. Then the server will send you the credentials to the browser. The browser will then, either it's Chrome or Edge, it will actually check the certificate that it is actually an authentic certificate, right? And once that has been done, a session can be created, right? Once the session can be created, then data is transmitted through the browser from the server back to the browser in an encrypted format. So that is the security that you get once you start using SSL certificate. So we do recommend that you guys protect X3 using an SSL certificate or communicate over HTTPS protocol then. Okay. All right. Okay. All right. So what does the process involve? So if you do go and purchase your certificate from the trusted, they are public, very, very fast sign, GoDaddy, there are a lot of them you can actually Google. I think the likes locally of Telkom as well does sell certificates, right? So you can actually go and buy. Then they will send you a PFX file, right? Then you can use that PFX file to generate your CA certificate and your public key, right? You can use common tools like your OpenSSL to do that, to do the generation of your CA certificates and public key. All right. So once you have done that, you then have to install the certificate on the web server. Okay. So once you have generated your CA and your public key, you then install it on the server. Then you register it, of course, in X3 to say, this is the certificate that I have, and this is the port that I want it to run on. Then you can have your connection secured with an SSL certificate. Okay. So again, if you check on the online help, you will see that only port 443 or 8443 or whatever is recommended for connection by the browser, right? All the other ports are not supposed, they are supposed to be secured internally. They are not supposed to be used by the browser to communicate or to transmit or to traffic any data from X3, right? The only communication that is recommended to communicate with the browser will be port 443 or your secured. You can use 8443. You can, as long as it is secured with an SSL certificate, then you can expose that to the browser. Right? All the other ports are supposed to be secured internally, and they are supposed to be communicating between the servers, right? And you should actually restrict access to such other ports, right? The only one that should be allowed to communicate over the internet is a secured port, right? That is the recommendation there. Okay, so, right, I will take this opportunity to just show you how you can actually generate the certificate, right? So Syracuse gives you the tool to actually, if you don't have the public one, you can actually generate the, it's recommended that, of course, you have the public one, since it, the browsers will be able to recognize the credentials that the web server will be sending, okay? I don't have a public one, so I will just generate my own. Then I will show you how you actually link or configure X3 to communicate with the certificates. Okay. So I have an X3 server that I have. Well, we do recommend that, of course, when you are doing your installation, you document everything, like your passwords, or as you build the server, document the information, right? So that you, if ever you have to either do a reinstallation, or if ever you have to, you actually have the information somewhere, recorded somewhere, so you can, if the passwords that you used, server names, port numbers, everything that you have used, you can actually go back and say, okay, this is where I get the information, right? So if you have protected your MongoDB, if you have protected your, you can actually go and use those, reuse the credentials that you had already used during the installation phase. Okay, so there's tools like in Apache, for example, there's OpenSSL. So should you require to OpenSSL.exe, should you require to convert your public, you can actually use OpenSSL to generate your CA certificate and your public key using OpenSSL. You just have to take this and the path where the OpenSSL is, and also where the config file will be. So if it's not in, and it's in this one, if it's not in the same folder as you have to, then go and use your environment variables to specify those paths as well, to say advanced settings. Yeah, then under path somewhere down here, you can edit, then you can come and add them, right? So that you, when you are typing your commands on the command prompt, it actually goes and pick the files in the appropriate folders. Okay, so, okay. So to generate your certificate using Syracuse, I think if you go in Syracuse, bin directory, right? There is setgen folder, right? And in setgen, you find a Java file to generate certificates there. So type cmd from this folder. Then did I get the command wrong? No, there's no underscore. There's no underscore. Okay, this command. Oh, sorry, double R. An R. Okay. All right. So it will actually say, do you want to create certificate and private key? Ask you for credentials. So country, ZA, state. Use GP, city, JHB, organization SAGE, Unity, customer services, name, this is the name of the user. So you can use administrator. Or any other username, say if you have a username called SageRT, you can use SageRT. Email is optional. Validity, you can put 3 years or I don't know how many, 5 years, if you want then. So it will say enter passphrase. You should have this information somewhere. Or you can regenerate the. So I'll just use. Right, this one it doesn't show. So you have to be careful. It does not show what you are typing. Right. Then it will tell you generate key, generate certificate. So it has generated a CA file. It has generated a CA key file and CA CRT file files there. Then the next step, it will actually ask you to create the certificate. So you can choose option one there. Right, it will ask you for the server name. If you don't remember server name, you can use Who Am I to. So it should be P12VM, I think. TCP connection, you can press enter. Doesn't matter. Number of days for validity. If you leave it empty, to put like 26 March 2025 there. Now it wants the server passphrase. So leave it the server passphrase there. It says it does not match. So I have to redo it again. One, X3. ERP, okay, this time it wants a port number 8124. Okay. So it has created and put in the files, right? So it will say in an output folder, right, the following files have been generated: your key, your CRT, and your PEM file. Okay, I can press enter to continue. Okay, then option 10 for end. Right, so if I go back to my folder, okay, set gen output. Okay, I should have my files generated. So this is the files that you then have to copy in your Syracuse sets folder, so that Syracuse can then use the file. So you can actually copy these files. I think first three will go in a specific folder. So if you copy the first three, you can actually go into Syracuse sets folder, then the name of your server, then you paste them in this file or in this subfolder for Syracuse, right? Since in your node local, check your node local file. Usually it's specified there if you did install Syracuse with certificates, right? So the path is specified in your node local. Then the PEM key, you can actually copy it into runtime. Right, so I think it will be say three. Runtime again. Runtime key. Keys, okay, yeah, right. So the PEM file, you paste it in the runtime, right? So from your output folder into the runtime folder, right? So once you have those files, you are good to go, right? You can actually go into X3 and present it from or configure in X3, right? So if you have a public certificate, there's three commands that you need to run on your command prompt, which takes your which takes your PFX file and output it to your domain CRT file, right? So it's usually like sage.pfx, then you output it to sage.crt, right? Then you can run the second command for the temp. The third command will then use the no key to generate now your actual public key, right? So you can use that one to generate the public key, right? So that should, the third command will then create your CRT and your key files. So the two files is exactly the same as the the ones that we generated in Syracuse. Syracuse bin directory. Said yeah, output. Right. So it will be this. And take note of the folders that it's the files are actually generated into, so that you can not confuse the files from older files or other files from that have been generated for different purposes, right? So you can then use the CRT and your key file to configure X3, right? So to configure X3, you log into X3 using 8.1.2.4. Okay. So once you are in X3, you can actually go to administration certificates, and then you can create your certificate there, maybe call it sage_X3 SSL. Certificate, then you can select your path. So under sets, your server name, Then you can select your CRT file, select the key. Okay, it will ask you for the passphrase again. Then you select your CA, select the server name. Then you can save it. Okay. I already have it, so I'm not going to resave it. Okay. All right. So once you have your certificate configured, you can now go to administration server hosts. Okay. So on your web server, right, you then configure the ports that are going to be secured or accessed by the users. Edit this. Then we'll say add port 443. And tick SSL. Then pick the certificate. Okay. Then save information. All right. So if it is actually a public certificate, now you'll be able to use HTTPS. Then your URL, it should be able to log into X3 over a secured network protocol. Okay, so that will be it from X3's side, right? So it's only two places in X3, right? Just make sure the actual certificate, the actual certificate is configured. Then on your web browser or your web server, sorry, under hosts, you link the port and the certificate. Okay. So it's only two places in X3 where that is done. Then that's it, you are done. Okay. So that is on generating your certificate or generating your CRT and your public key. Right. Now on best practice. So always recommended to have a test server ready, right? So if the client does not have a test server, have your own VM ready where you can actually test the certificate that the client is sent to you or that you have purchased from your third party certificate authorities, right? So you have that test server ready, configure the certificate on the test server and check what that everything is working fine. The encryptions are being done. You can actually use the certificate or it is working as per recommendations, right? Then take note of the output files, right? The locations, just take note of that, right? Make sure you are not outputting it to either the wrong folders, then you are copying the old files and you are replacing and everything will end up not working again. And do backups, of course, before you change anything, you have your folders copied somewhere else so that should anything happen, you are able to restore back to a working position. Then, of course, MongoDB. So anything that you configure in X3 under administration module is saved under MongoDB. So yeah, make sure that you have saved, you have configured your MongoDB, or get to a state where it was working before any changes. You start to do any changes. So you have your backup for your Mongo dump ready before you start making any alterations to the system. Okay. Then it is also recommended that you do not deactivate port 842, right? 8142. So port 8142, this one, for debugging purposes and for, right, should anything happen with your SSL, don't deactivate this one before you have made sure that your HTTPS URL is working fine properly without any issues, right? So you should be able to then revert back to use 8142. Like we said, it's in an internal port, should be secured through either firewalls, so that it doesn't allow outbound external communications through 8124. It's only an internal port, so make sure that it's active, so that should anything happen, you can always use that one to log into X3 and make the required changes, if any. Okay. Right. Yeah, if anything else, sure. Yeah, so yes, that's for SSL, secure protocol layer. I will open the floor for questions. If anyone has any questions, then we can, yeah. Andrew.
Yes, thanks, Janae. We do have a question that has come through. How to set up my existing wildcard SSL certificate in Sage? So I think maybe this question is, how do I set up my existing wildcard SSL certificate, Sage X3? I don't think, do you want to take this one, or this one requires more elaboration or more steps?
Yeah, no. So it's actually the same. I'm sure it's only you use a star on the
okay, Janae, there's also a response. Yeah. Somebody has responded. Carol, thanks. Carol says, you just follow the same steps as shown, the same steps, yes, that you have used. So the same steps should actually suffice. Ashish, what I can recommend for you to do, if you probably missed some of the steps, is to check when we post this video on our YouTube channel. If then you will follow the, watch the recording again, and then there's a documentation that is going to come as well, that is also on Sage City, that is going to be followed with links to take you to more content on configuring the SSL certificate.
Yes.
Okay, I think those are the questions. We did post some polls during the presentation. If you can just respond to the polls that we did. Okay, there's another question. Please share the link of Sage X3 Help Online to configure SSL certificate. Okay, we'll share the link with you just now.
Yeah, we can do that, no problem.
Okay, do you have the link?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Oh. Okay, let me see if I still have the actual presentation open. Okay, I've posted it in chat. I don't have access to chat. Okay, posted.
Okay, let's see if there any, you feel free to post questions and also to respond to our poll. Okay, I think you can wind up. We don't have any more questions, Junaid. I think you can just wind up and then again, we okay. Encourage you to go on Sage City and also on our YouTube channel for X3 for support. And you'll find the videos and also on Sage City, you will find more articles on posting. Okay, so YouTube channel, Jordi will send you the link to the YouTube channel once we have posted it. So you will not have access to this Teams meeting after we close it. So the recording will be posted on YouTube for everyone else that is outside of Sage. But if you are within Sage, you'll be able to get the recording in our SharePoint. So for the rest, you'll find the link. The link will be posted on our YouTube channel. Jordi will send you the link to the YouTube channel. Okay, any last words, Junaid?
Yeah, so my last words is, of course, it is recommended that we for security purposes, there are certain Syracuse versions that every client should be on. So if you check on our Sage City, there were security hot fixes that were done, I think it was a year or so ago. Clients have to be on certain Syracuse components for security purposes. They actually did put in protection so that the data is securely encrypted from an X3 point of view. So yeah, we recommend that you patch up most of the clients to those recommended patch levels and the component levels. That's it from me. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Junaid. And once again, I want to thank all of you for taking the time to attend our webinar for this month of June. I've also posted a survey in the chat as well. Please take time to respond to the survey. This will help us in our planning and also on choosing topics that you want to you want us to cover in the future presentation. Thanks very much, Junaid, for your first presentation. Let's give Junaid a round of applause. That was his first presentation. I know it takes a lot to really get these things going. Thanks very much, Renee. And hopefully we will see you again in future presentations. So for the rest of us, thank you very much for joining, and we hope to see you soon. Thank you. Oh, so there's one just question that came there. What is the YouTube channel name? It is Sage X3 support. If you go on the Sage on YouTube, there are quite a number of videos that you can watch. If you look for Africa and Middle East, and then you look for customer success, and then you will find the videos. But the shortest way to go to the correct website, to the correct YouTube channel, is to go through Sage City X3, and then under Sage City X3, then you click on videos, and then it will take you directly to our YouTube channel. Okay, so with that said, again, thank you very much and have a good day, and stay warm if you are in the winter seasons like here in South Africa. Thank you.
Okay, cheers, bye.
Yes.